Hi friends, I get questions all the time about these videos. How do I record these videos? Do I use any sort of teleprompter software? Am I using some amazing Nikon or Canon camera? Like, how am I doing this? And I really wanted to tell you today every single piece of equipment that I use when I record these videos because it is so low tech and you can do it too. And I want to make sure that you are doing videos because actually these days, YouTube is one of the number one places where people are finding information. In fact, it is the second most used search engine after Google. When people want to know information, they come to YouTube and they search out a video on it. And if you're offering something that is meant to help the world, that you have to offer some sort of piece of information or some methodology or healing modality or whatever it is that you're offering, a great place to be is on YouTube because people are searching for information here. People who know that they need something are going to find you if the thing that you offer is what they need. So I wanted to just show you how absolutely simple it is. You do not need to do anything fancy. Okay, now it just so happens that today I'm recording this on my computer because I needed to have the other thing that I usually record with so I can show it to you, okay? So this video is actually slightly different than most of my videos. I'm actually recording you using the Zoom record option. If you have Zoom video conferencing, you can just hit record. You can open a meeting with yourself and hit record, and here we are. So that's one way that you can record. It's just all you need to do is make sure that your little recorder screen is clean. And so before I did this video, I just used this little 3M notebook and tablet cleaning wipe to clean off my video camera because I wanted to make sure that there was no fuzz on it. Sometimes I've had, like, you know, grease from my finger or something on there and it makes it fuzzy and that's not good. So that is all you literally need to do if you want to record on your computer. Now, if you want to record on your computer, sometimes you might want to use some sort of a microphone. And that's because computer audio isn't like the best. Now, I have recorded videos before using just my computer audio, and it actually does work fine. So if that's all you've got, go for it. That's all you've got. You can also use a headset. Many people you'll see they're going to record and they're wearing sort of like a headphones, or they're even wearing earbuds with the microphone on the cord. That is totally fine as well. I happen to be a little more vain than that, and I don't want to mess up my hair. So I never use a microphone like that. Usually what I do is simply record with the audio on the recording device that I'm going to show you in just a moment, which is where I usually record. But if you're doing like what I'm doing right now on your computer, you can either use the computer recording or you can use your headset, headphones, earbud, or if you want to get a little more fancy, you can get a microphone, an external microphone like this one. So I'm actually using this one right now, so it's going to sound a little funny if I pull it away from my mouth, but this is the Yeti from Blue. So this particular microphone model is called the Yeti. It's very highly recommended. One of my favorite websites, wirecutter.com. If you're a shopaholic and you like to get the best of everything, I've just given you the tip of the day. Wirecutter recommends this as their number one podcasting microphone. I've had it for a couple of years. I haven't used it very much except for when I'm recording audio on my computer, which is pretty rare. I've done it when I've recorded a meditation. I've used it when I have been on someone's teleconference or podcast and I'm using Skype to record or to call in. I'll use the Yeti because the sound is so much clearer. But you don't need one of these, but if you want something a little fancier, especially if you're going to be podcasting, this is the microphone to get, the Yeti. And it's usually around $100 on Amazon or any online retailer. Okay, so that's one option, is to record on your computer. Another option, which is the one that I use every other video you have ever seen me on this YouTube channel. I have used the setup I'm about to show you. And I'm a little embarrassed about it actually, because people are like, you what? I record, what is the recording device I use? My phone. That's it. I just use my iPhone. I've used an iPhone 6. I now happen to have the 10XR, I think, or XS. I don't remember. It doesn't quite matter which one you use. It's all fine. Most of these videos that you've seen on my YouTube channel are recorded on an iPhone 6. And I don't use any external mic at all. The only thing I use is this. I record straight from here into here. And you've seen it. It's fine. It is absolutely fine. You know, it's the way that I like to record is a step up from the absolute base layer that's available today. Many people record actual videos for their business in their car, right? Or they record it sort of on a selfie stick walking around the house. Like, I prefer to have a little bit more of a professional vibe sitting down. I'm obviously in a room that I have set up. You know, this is my living room, but I really like the way it looks and I like the background. It feels like me. But honestly, like, you literally do not need to go super fancy. You can go anywhere along the spectrum. Mine is a little fancier than others because I'm just sitting down and I'm not in my car. But I don't have a professional production team. I've never worked with a professional video team, nothing. I have purchased like the video umbrella lighting and like the backdrops. And honestly, I've never used any of it. I don't even think you need that, especially as you're getting started. If you're just getting your information into the world, do it as easy as you can. So I record on my phone, but I don't use my hand. I don't use a selfie stick. I happen to use this little setup right here. Okay, so this is a setup. I decided to show you the truth, which is that I haven't even taken the plastic off of this little ring, lighting thing, right? This is just to make sure that if the lighting is not great in the room, that it actually, I have enough light on my face that you can see me. Now, in this particular video that I'm doing right now, I have no lighting at all. I'm literally sitting in front of a window. That's another tip: sit in front of a window at a time of day when there's ambient light coming into the window. So set up your camera right in the window, and that's where I am right now. But oftentimes I will use this just to make sure I don't have any shadows on my face, etc. Okay. This is a tripod. It's a short-ish tripod. It's not one that you can put on the floor and be standing up. I actually can't even put it on the floor while I'm sitting. I actually always have it on a table and I have it slightly higher than my head because, as we selfie takers know, this is the most flattering angle that there is slightly higher. You definitely don't want it to be slightly lower. I mean, people do it all the time. You can do whatever you want, but like, really, I think slightly higher just makes it a little bit better. And then I arrange phone. I just plug it in here. See, just put the phone in here. It's just got this little clippy clamp. And I'm going to give you all the information for all of these in the comments below. So look down in the description and you will see where you can get all of these things as of the time of recording. Can't promise a year from now, but as of the time of recording, I'll put links in there. Okay, so this is just your this is a basic, super basic tripod with this lighting system is just like clipped on like this, right? And then I put in my phone and I arrange the light up here and I set it to record on my phone. And I have this usually on a table and I use my finger. People can't believe it when I say this. I don't use a clicker. I don't use a remote. I just use my finger and I press record. And then I sit back and I usually say, "Hi, Alexandra." She's my wonderful marketing person who edits my videos for me. And we don't do very much editing at all. We literally just clip the front end, clip the back end. But I just say, "Hey, Alexandra." And then I arrange my hair because, you know, you gotta arrange your hair, right? Then I arrange my hair. Looking pretty. Make sure I look pretty. And then I just say, "Hey friends, today I want to talk to you about XYZ. You've seen it before. You've seen me do these videos over and over again." And then I send that unedited video over to Alexandra and she adds in a title using iMovie. It's very simple. I could probably do it, but she knows how to do it. So it takes her way less time than it would take me to figure it out. And she just clips the front end, adds in a title, clips the back end. And that is how we create a video. Now she does, there's one more hint. Before I record the video, I take a still camera shot of myself, which you'll see we use as the still that you see on the video on the YouTube channel, because if you leave it up to YouTube, they'll give you like three options for screenshots. But unfortunately, sometimes they're all like, and then nothing is flattering. And so as I am a bit vain, I want to make sure that I have a really nice photo that we can use for that front shot when we're putting the title on it. So you can see when you scroll through my YouTube channel, there's individual shots. And each one of those was a photograph that I took before I put the, before I started the camera and got rolling. So as for the question of whether I use a teleprompter, I absolutely 100% do not use a teleprompter. I'm leaning down to show you because I just actually recorded a video. Sometimes I'll take notes and I'll actually have them like taped next to my phone, but that's actually rare. I usually kind of know what I'm talking about. And this is the key. If you are recording a video about something that where you're the expert, you will already know this stuff. And it doesn't have to be super polished. It doesn't have to be perfect. You can stumble over your words here and there. It's fine. The information just needs to get out. Okay. So you start off the video by saying, this is what I'm going to tell you about, because you want to make sure that people are watching the right video. And then you tell them about it. And then at the end, you say something like, hey, subscribe to this channel because I'm giving you great information, like this information about how to record videos all the time, every week. Please, I hope that you'll be a part of it. And usually people do. So that is my video for the day. How I do my videos, super simple, using my iPhone. I'm going to put all the information for this like basic equipment that I have that's not expensive in the description below so you can buy your own. And I would love to see you starting a YouTube channel. And if you do, please let me know in the comments so I can come and check it out. All right, everybody. I hope you have a wonderful week. Happy writing, happy platform building, and I will see you again soon.